Very good morning. My name is Prashant Lingam. I'm from UNDP Classic Race Management Project team. So today we have gathered to, you know, share some learnings and experiences and on plastic waste and its management. So we'll be spending some 25 to 35 minutes to share what exactly is the current scenario of plastic waste in India and how it is managed and how students can contribute their bit in this whole sector. So let's start. As you all know, plastic has become a very serious issue and it's being taken up and addressed at a larger level across the globe. The very main reason why it is considered an issue or a problem statement is because it does not degrade for years together. That is the very one reason why there are a lot of organizations and individuals trying to find a solution for this pressing issue. And one more recently, as we all, you all definitely must have come across videos and newsletters and information or across social media and news that it has started affecting our marine life also. So a lot of videos has become viral also in the last few years. And the main reason is not plastic per se. It is not the plastic. It is our behavioral reasons and the behavioral issues or the irresponsible littering of plastics. So there is this normal lot of voice and noise across everywhere that plastic is bad. Please note that plastic is not bad. Our littering is an issue basically. That is what is creating this chaos right now. So today we will be discussing around 5 points. All the 5 points you can see on the screen. So we will try to give you some basic information on plastics and what are the advantages and disadvantages of plastics. And the backbone of the entire sector, we in the project call them as Safai Sathis or Safai Mitras. In a normal language, they are even called like waste pickers or rag pickers. What is their importance? How they are supporting our environment and society with their work is what we'll discuss. And the next is what exactly is UNDP doing on this issue? And what are the expectations from you young change makers, schools, you know, your teachers, your friends, your society, your colony, all put together. So let's start. So what exactly is plastics? So and where, how is it like? What is the basic premise of the whole thing? It is a Greek word plus plastikos, which means able to be shaped. When you heat something and you mold it and it gets into a particular shape. The first invention was done in 1856. And in 1925, the word plastic came to this world. That's what is the basic origin. So there are broadly 7 types of plastics. So first is PET. Your Bisleri water bottle or your bottles you have in your refrigerators, that can be identified as PET. Second is HT, that is second, your juice bottles, your detergents, your shampoo bottles in your bathroom. Third is PVC. The best way to recognize PVC is your plumbing pipes. In all your residences, inside the bathroom or outside the bathroom, you can see plumbing lines going. So that is one example. And next is LD. One easy way of identifying LD is your milk packets or your milk cartons, which is flexible. That is one. PP, you can say your luggage, your furniture, your food containers. Next is polystyrene, or styrofoam. You can say packaging, you know, your containers or packaging. That is one. And the last one, mostly is PET, HD, LD, PP. These are the 4 more. There are few other things which we will discuss with the course of the presentation. So broadly, you need to identify this. Please see the chart. We will share the presentation also with you so that you can go through once again. So now in this chart, you can see we have some figures from 96 to 2007, how the consumption in India has gone up from, from very low in 96 to the current figure of 2017. And if you look at 2021, it's continuously going. Though our consumption is growing, but on a global scale, we are still extremely less. Our per capita consumption is extremely less. If you notice, US is the maximum. We are much below the global average also. So now, since we have seen few slides where I've been talking about that plastic consumption is growing in India and globally also, but India, which is the maximum consumption in which sector or in which area? So for us, it is packaging. So all our plastic waste comes, or the use of plastics is maximum is in packaging. And the rest is infrastructure, automobile, agriculture, and other sectors. So it's on par with at times that, in packaging, we are more than the global average. In automobile, we are less than the global average. In agriculture, we are almost on par. So the main purpose of showing these figures and charts is so that from tomorrow, when you look into a packaging, you will understand, okay, my package has so much of plastic waste. Is there anything I can do to reduce? Can I find out a way? Can I innovate? Can I, really work on this issue? That was the main reason. In the previous slides, you have seen that, per capita consumption of plastic is very high. So that means per individual, per household, maybe some analysis you can do in your own house where you can see, okay, my family or it's coming so much of plastic is coming into the house. Is there anything I can reduce so that I can contribute my bit also? So go to the next slide. Okay, now we come to the recycling part. Most of the plastic which is generated, the plastic waste which gets generated is recycled. And India's recycling rate is extremely high compared to the local global rate. So it's almost 60%. So we almost recycle our entire plastic. So in what forms we will discuss. So it's a very big industry in India right now. There are a lot of people associated and involved with the recycling of plastic waste. So we will go in the corresponding. Okay, now we have seen some figures, we have gone through the numbers also, what is plastics we have gone through. Now let us come, why is plastics, used so heavily? Why is the consumption so high? So these are some parameters we have identified why it is being heavily used. First is, of course, low cost. The cost is extremely low. That is one. It's water resistant, it's corrosion proof. So we will discuss something what is more than given in the slide, because what is in the slides is anyway visible. So generally it's extremely lightweight. So that is, and it's extremely strong. So these are the two reasons. It's very lightweight, it's easy to carry, the wear and tear is less, and it's heavily used in packaging. Whenever you pack something, your material should not get damaged. So that's where you use plastic, and it's lifelong also. So these are the few parameters, few reasons why plastic is being so heavily used. So we can see in today's life, it has penetrated so much. There's hardly any item we can identify. Maybe if you're sitting on your desk, or if you're in front of your system, you can notice your laptop is of plastic, your phone is of plastic, your comb, there's hardly any item, your TV, your refrigerator, your air conditioners, your headphones, maybe few of us might be using our headphones right now. So there's hardly any item which does not have presence of plastic. So that's the deep use we have plastics today. So the advantages at times are the disadvantages also, you know. And why we are talking today, why we have assembled today, is the very basic reason is it does not degrade. It takes hundreds and hundreds of years for plastic to degrade, and that is the biggest problem. So something which we are throwing today from our house will stay for more than 500 years. So we should be extremely cautious and careful while using plastics and disposing also. So from our bit, we should definitely try this. And another reason is what we might be thinking, okay, I'm just throwing in my house bin. What difference does it make? But it is today, all the waste which is coming from our house is finding its way into oceans in the form of microplastics. You know, that is one thing we all should be extremely careful while using or throwing. We have to ensure that, you know, we are not responsible for our plastic used is finding its way into oceans. And the process of manufacturing of plastics also release high CO2. And one most important thing I would like to share with you all is it should never be burnt. So at times in your colonies or in your locality, you must definitely have seen or might see in future where you see, you know, somebody is burning plastic. So please ensure you stop them and you tell them this is not to be done. It should go through a proper challenge through the municipal authorities only. So that's one thing. So the fourth point equally we're talking about, because apart from marine life, we can see that even animals in the municipal dumping grounds starts feeding on them. So that's another reason. These are the four main reasons why. These are the disadvantages. Of course, it has its advantages, but this has the disadvantages also. So again, I would like to reiterate, plastic per se is not a bad material. It's probably the best invention of mankind. It is our littering habits which is causing all these problems in the environment today. So now I would like to share what exactly we at UNDP are doing in this plastic waste management project. So we work in partnerships. You can see we have partners in Coca-Cola, HUL, HDFC Bank, CCIF. So along with them, and along with our other stakeholders or our partners, I would call, we work with state pollution control boards, we work with municipal authorities also, where, and of course, as you can see, our Safai Sathis, the most important people. So it's a joint partnership of so many people where we are trying to address the issue of plastic waste and ensure we are able to collect as much as we can and process as much as we can. That's the whole project all about. In this, we have four major pillars of our project. I would not take much of a time on this because but still you can go through it. In this, I'll explain one of the most important concept of this project is establishment of Swachhata Kendra. We call it Swachhata Kendra, where we establish Swachhata Kendra or material recovery center along with the local municipality in the municipal dumping ground or wherever the land is allocated to us. There, our Safai Sathis collect all the plastic waste and we follow proper systems and practices and knowledge management, and where all the plastic collected is sent to recycling. So that is one of the most important. And one more important is knowledge management. So in communication, so IEC activity, where we try to sensitize, you know, citizens about the whole ecosystem. What exactly is plastic? How we all as a society, through our individual efforts and action, can address this. So this is in broad, I can say in short, about our exact activity. And in this, our Safai Sathis, again, I would like to reiterate, are the most important. So point number three, which you can see, we work with them, we try to ensure their dignity and respect in the society. So please ensure whenever you are seeing whenever you see a waste picker or waste pickings community or somebody working in sanitation, so they are the most important people who are working with us and who are supporting the environment today. Okay, now you can see the same thing which I was talking in the last slide. So you might be thinking like, how they make money. In this slide, as you have seen, we have written it brings food to their table. So they all the plastic waste which is generated in the city goes to a municipal dumping ground. There, all our Safai Sathis collect it. And all this is sent to recycling. So that is how they make a livelihood. And that's a tremendous and commendable job which they are doing for our environment and society today. And it's our responsibility to ensure, it's a collective responsibility to ensure they get their respect and dignity. Which at times, we overlook their contribution. So that has to be, so I would request as students that, you can voice your opinion on the contribution of Safai Sathis to our society. Okay, now this has been some basics. Now exactly what you all as students can do to address this problem. So we're talking about plastic littering problem. So we have given a chart, hierarchy chart. First thing is, least favored options and most favored options. First thing is, we should try as much as we can, where all it's possible. It's impossible to remove plastics overnight from our lives. It's extremely difficult. So we have to start, we take a very conscious call on in our day-to-day activities, where I can reduce. So you just need to map for 30 days, what all is coming into your house or what all is coming to your school collectively. So what is the material? What is the material which is come? Is there anything I can substitute with this? So let's talk about few examples. So firstly, take PET bottles. So if you are using PET bottles, maybe you can take a call. Okay, I'm using PET. Can I substitute PET bottle? Can I use a terracotta bottle? Can I use a copper bottle? Can I use a bamboo bottle? So similarly, not only to bottles, we use earbuds. We use, plastic earbuds. So nowadays there are alternatives. There are eco-friendly alternates to it. So cutlery or, spoons or forks and all, which is made out of plastics. So that can be substituted with your steel spoons or steel forks or wooden, or there are so many materials, alternate materials today. So can I do that? So first thing is to reduce and find alternates to your daily consumption. Second, assumingly you couldn't find an alternate, and it happens at times. It's not that you will always find an alternate. If you feel you're not able to find an alternate, second is to find a way to reuse. Can I use it? For example, let us again go back to the example of PET. So used a PET, instead of throwing it, can you make a pencil box out of it? Can you make a light out of it? Can I make a lamp out of it? So can we do something on these lines? So the best resources, if you go to Google or if you just search across the net with a search string, creative ideas using PET bottles or creative ideas using plastic covers, you will find so many resources where you will see creative work being done instead of throwing. But please do all this in under the guidance of your teachers or parents or somebody elder. So that is one. Third is recycle. Means, okay, this is one step where I will show in the subsequent slide exactly. We will talk more on recycling. Your next is recovery, and last should be disposal. You should try your level best to ensure you are not disposing what you have. Keep finding alternates. Today, first step is reducing. Maybe with course of time, as you you know, start your journey in this subject, you will definitely come across a point where you will have solutions to avoid disposal also. So you start at reduce, you start at R and come at D over a period of time. So this is one hierarchical chart. So let's move to the next slide. So you must have heard, or if those who have heard it, it's extremely good. Those who are, you know, hearing it or seeing this for the first time, so call it Binet, right? So in your house also, let's start with house and then go to your school. In your house, especially your kitchen, you must definitely, all of us have a dustbin at house. The first thing is to have separate bins for wet and dry. So that is the first thing we all should do. So those who have, it's extremely good. Where it's not available, I request you to tell your parents or your authorities at school. So let's have separate bins for our wet and dry waste. Once you segregate, that's the first step for us. Then second is identifying your various type of plastics, which we have seen in the initial slides. There are 7 type of plastics. So you will slowly, with time, you'll definitely get a good grip on the different types of plastics. And most important thing is, please don't shy away on discussing the issue of waste or waste management or plastics with your friends and family. And I suggested, internet is a very good resource for point number 3 of finding innovative solutions, how you can use not only plastic waste, other forms of waste. Other forms of waste. What are the innovative solutions we can find to address the problem of this? If you notice, the point number 4, your wet and recyclable and hazardous should always be separate. In houses, definitely we don't have that much of hazardous waste. So wherever it is there, even at times if you feel this is a hazardous waste, that needs to be separated. As I discussed, the point number 4, wet and dry should never be mixed together in the same bin. So the next point about single-use plastic, you know, you all must have been hearing a lot about single-use plastics. So it has been one major reason of this issue and, you know, plastic issue. Single-use is something where we use once and we just throw it off. Means we don't use it again. So there is, that is one. So for example, let's come to your earbuds made of plastics. We throw it. Your straw, your plastic straw. Once we use it, we don't reuse it. So same way, you definitely might have seen where you go to an ice cream parlor where he gives you your ice cream scoop in a plastic cup with a plastic spoon. And while coming, we throw. So maybe next time when you go to a shop where you are having your ice creams or any your food, you will notice the moment you have in your hand, it will ring a bell in your, so that you can always tell ki bhaiya ye aap plastic mein kyun de rahe ho, why don't you find an alternate for this. Agar aapke school mein aapko lagta hai ki aapke canteen mein ki ki plastic hai, single use hai, fir se use nahi hoga ye, so you can always ask or request your school authorities or the canteen in charge as a collectively ki kya hum isko band kar sakte hain, iska koi alternative dhoond sakte hain. That is one thing. And next and the last thing, so definitely when your waste is generated, please separate it. Please separate it and hand it over to your Safai Sathi or the vehicle which comes to your house. Why we are emphasizing and stressing so much of segregation is, it becomes difficult for the Safai Sathis to segregate when wet, dry, plastics, hazardous, everything is mixed in one bin. So I'll tell you a small case where we keep hearing from our Safai Sathi friends when they are segregating. Once it seems they notice that there is a syringe and it did hurt someone. The syringe was mixed in our household waste. So they open the bag. So while they are sorting, it pierced him. In another, one more incident, once happened there was a cough syrup bottle. I think it was broken in the home and they just dumped into this. So while opening, again, it had a cut. So these are, you know, we have to be very sensitive towards people who are segregating our waste. That is the most important thing. And at the ground level, if everything is, you know, segregated, it can find a proper channel very easily. If it mixed, it's very difficult. So that is one thing. Please practice segregation at source. So separate all your waste and separate bins. So that's one thing we definitely expect from the student community and all of you. And of course, please talk on this with your family and friends and teachers also. So let's move to the next slide. So now what exactly are we all looking to do? What we want you to do, what is expected of you, what you all can do. So let's go point by point. So minimize as much as you can the use of plastic, or there is another term, it's called plastic footprint. So identify your plastic footprint, means assumingly today is 1st of June. So you start writing in your notebook how much plastic I have used, how much plastic I have consumed, how much has come to the house. From today, start mapping that after 30 days and find a plan that how can I reduce this. So keep writing or keep slowly reducing your plastic footprint at home and collectively in school also. So that is one. And secondary, as we discussed, segregate your plastic waste and give it to the collector. Whoever is going to collect, please forward it to them separately in a separate bag. So if you do it home, then you can ensure this is practiced in your colony, or it's practiced in your apartment, it's practiced in your school. So that goes a long way. That goes a very long way. And please ensure neither are you burning nor anybody is burning. Or if you see somebody burning plastic, please educate them that this should not be done. And as we discussed, reuse. We discussed about, you know, finding resources and internet and using Google to find what are the various ways, you know, smaller ways where under, you know, in supervision, you can, you know, find ways to recycle plastic. Reuse, and of course, recycling, we are going to talk in the next slide. The most important thing which we all do when we go to grocery, when we go to buy vegetables, when we go to supermarkets, you know, out of ignorance at time, you know, the shop owner gives us the plastic bags and we, you know, out of ignorance at times, we take it. So please ensure you're not using any plastic bag from the grocery store. Instead, you take a bag, you take a cotton bag, or, you know, from your side, whichever bag you want to take, so that your consumption is coming down. And the last point, so please promote the usage of alternate materials which can be substituted with plastics where all you can use, and you know, discuss within yourself that it should not be littered. So again, I would like to reiterate, littering is a bigger problem. So you should ensure you're not throwing, you know, means we see people who are walking on the road and they are, you know, they throw packets, they throw bottles on the roads, and, you know, and it finds a ways into animals and it finds ways into a marine also. So that the littering is the main problem. If we collect it properly, give it to somebody who's going to collect, it will find a way through a proper channel. That is one thing you all can do. And one more thing, you can talk to your school authorities. If you can have a very large bin in school, where all the students collectively every day or every week or every month, they can bring the plastic to the school and deposit there. And school authorities will ensure it's going to a proper channel. So just imagine if you have, you know, 1,000 students in a school or 500 students school, you know, and every week, every one of you is depositing the plastics. So see how much properly it is will be channelized. So that is one more thing we would all want all of you to do. Next, yes, we have been talking about recycling. So these are the products which are being currently, there are more, we have just given some basic idea. On the right, it is a roofing sheet. On your left, it is a furniture. Again, on the right bottom, it is a brick made out of plastic waste, and it's a writing pad. You all use writing pads in your exams. And on the left corner, you can see it is a collection bin for plastic waste. So, which UNDP has been promoting heavily, where we install these in institutions, schools, and colleges where everybody can deposit their plastic waste. So, these are some products which are currently being made. So, if we all channelize our waste properly, it will find way into a finished product, and this is called circularity. So till now we were talking about recycling, and this is about circularity, where it finds way back to us again. So some product is made. So just imagine all the plastic waste which is collected in your school, after processing, comes back to you as a furniture, or it comes back to you as a writing pad. It is so amazing that all your effort is again has, you know, reaped something, and you are able to physically see what has happened to the waste, which otherwise would have lied for centuries and centuries on this earth. So thank you very much. So this is what is our brief presentation to share. It's extremely little what, you know, it's an ocean of a subject. So what we are trying to do is sensitize, and, you know, it's a small seed where we are trying to put into you, so that from here you take on with your family and friends. So I'll just stop the sharing once. So thank you very much. We look forward to associating and discussing with you again. And if you have any suggestions, or if you have any queries, or if you want to discuss something, how you can further take it up with this initiative, you can always reach out to the UNDP team. We will try our level best to ensure we collectively are addressing this problem. Please note, this is not an individual effort. We all have to collectively work on this. Only then we all will have a better future for tomorrow. Thank you very much. Stay safe.